What's up? What's up? You already know what this is. AMD's smart access memory has been ported over to Intel, sort of. See, the feature allows a Ryzen 5000 series processor to have full access to the GPU memory of a Radeon RX 6000 series GPU, which can have a decent impact on performance. That does sound smart, haha. But SAM is actually based on a technology called resizable base address register, or resize bar, which has been a part of the PCIe spec for years. Nvidia has said they're working on adding the feature to their GPUs, while some motherboard makers have already released BIOS updates that enable bar on Intel Z490 motherboards, including Asus and ASRock, who named their implementation Clever Access Memory. Oh my god. Some early testing has been done showing that a system with an Intel 10900K and an RX 6800 XT could gain performance by as much as 16%. This is great news for Intel, but if some Rocket Lake leaks are accurate, they're gonna need every extra boost they can get. Ha! That was a rocket pun.
Maybe they should ask Elon Musk for help.
Comes in a rocket can! Google is in hot water, whatever that means when you're one of the richest companies on earth, over its treatment of current and former employees. The US National Labor Relations Board has filed a complaint against the tech giant for illegally surveilling employees and firing those who attempt to unionize. The complaint alleges that Google blocked employees from sharing work grievances and information with each other using email, calendars, and even physical meeting rooms. At first I was like, well, this is their fault for using Gmail and other G Suite. Yeah, but meeting rooms. Hey, Google, send Karen a message about how Google sucks.
I'm sorry, James. I can't do that.
There's also controversy surrounding Timnit Gebru, a research scientist on Google's ethical AI team. Gebru was fired after questioning a manager's request that she retract a research paper that she had written discussing how AI systems can sometimes demonstrate racial bias. Now, hundreds of Google employees have signed an open letter calling Gebru's firing unprecedented research censorship. The best part is, Google doesn't even have to take any of this seriously since they removed "Don't be evil" from their motto, and obviously mottos,
they're legally binding.
They're binding.
Yeah.
So they're free. They couldn't be legal before, but now they can't. And stock shortages continue to affect sales of graphics cards, with retailers selling out of basically everything as soon as they refresh their stock. Well, you can help them sell out even faster by joining the thousands of people currently watching a stock checker bot stream its stock checking on Twitch. Sure, the screen is entirely composed of slowly updating lists of GPU models with big red text reading out, "Out of stock." But what else would you do with your time in these unprecedented times where you have so much time? What would you do? Figure out which graphics settings to turn down so your current graphics card can play Cyberpunk, which isn't even gonna get made anyway? What, watch the new episode of MANDALORIAN? No thanks. If you do enjoy this type of entertainment, you're in luck. Nvidia says that thanks to wafer shortages and other impacts on the supply line thanks to COVID, stock shortages are probably going to be the norm for the next couple of months. So grab the popcorn. The Mandalorian is okay, at best, anyway.
You don't even watch it.
Yeah, because it sucks.
It's pretty good now.
I've seen enough. Now it's time for the Quick Bits, brought to you by Brilliant, the website and app that makes learning accessible and fun instead of boring crappy memorization tasks. Brilliant's approach is based on problem solving and active learning. You'll encounter concepts visually, with courses laid out like bite-sized pieces of a story that you can interact with and swallow whole. Delicious. There's no tests or grades. You just pick a course you're interested in and get started. Whether you want to learn programming, brush up on your algebra, or dive into the science of neural networks, my favorite kind of network. The first 200 people who head to brilliant.org/techlinked will get 20% off their annual premium subscription, so click the link below. And get smart.
Get smart.
Come on. Quick Bits roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping. Oh, photos of a phone called the Pixel XE have leaked online, or at least that's what the device thinks it is, according to the About Phone section. It doesn't look like any Pixel phone released so far, so this could indeed be Google's next flagship. Pretty rude of them to just steal Intel's graphics brand like that, but again, evil isn't out of the question here, am I right? They're making the Pixel!
They're making the Pixel!
I hope they call it Z instead of XE, that's stupid. Hackers have been targeting the global supply chain responsible for distributing COVID vaccines, according to analysts from IBM's comic book sounding X-Force Iris division. It's suspected the hackers aren't attempting to disrupt vaccine distribution, that would be disgusting, but are trying to harvest
credentials to get close to the myriad corporations and countries involved in the effort. But it might screw things up anyway, so can you just take a break for a second, hackers? Can you just take your boot off of the throat of 2019 as it gasps for air? Verizon is trying to fix a glitch in their live chat support service that shows customers logs of previous chat sessions from other customers when they open a chat window. Yikes. This info can include names, addresses, phone numbers, and account numbers, and Verizon was notified of the issue by Ars Technica on Monday. But the glitch is still there today on Friday. Maybe they didn't have reception or something.
Can you hear me now?
For some reason, your email was in my junk. It just got here. Warner Brothers Pictures has announced the studio's entire 2021 lineup of movies will release simultaneously in theaters and on HBO Max, including big boys like Dune and The Matrix 4. Okay, this does not mean that all those movies are coming out on the same day. Okay, there's been clickbait titles going around. Awesome is what I would say if this wasn't limited to the US only. Do you want piracy? Because this is how you get piracy. And ants.
What about Canada?
And Chinese physicists claim to have built a quantum computer that completed a task in just over 3 minutes that would have taken the world's fastest conventional classical computer 600 million years to finish. The quantum machine used a process called Gaussian boson sampling, which works exactly the way you would expect. The researchers say that this means they've achieved quantum supremacy, even though Google already declared the same thing. These guys are even more supreme. They're supremer. But I think technically all you have to do is declare it and you have it. It's like bankruptcy. I declare this episode is over. Come back on Monday for more tech news. I'll be roasted over an open fire, supremely, quantumly. Stuff me like a turkey.